Hello, wonderful people. My name is José Dorrego. I have been a physical comedian for the last 29 years. My journey started in a small social circus school in Cape Town called the Zip Zap Circus School. And I started being a professional artist at the age of 18. I created a bench act with my acrobatic partner. His name is Kagiso Mutlana. And we were called the Joker Boys. But then Monsieur Alan Pashvi saw our video and he invited us to perform at Festival Cirque du Dama, and I think it was in 2007. And from there, it started my journey with the Cirque Phoenix family. After that, I had worked for them for 12 years, every year. And it was a very memorable experience. I performed various numbers as the head character or the head clown character at Cirque Phoenix. I did a number with Gumboots and a Vuvuzela, and was public. I had public members on the stage. I also played a character, sort of a tourist going to Cuba for the first time. And yeah, so I played various roles throughout the shows. But yeah, ideally at the end of the day, I'm a physical comedian, and that's was my job at Cirque Phoenix, make the people laugh and take them on a journey. I think the first was, it was a bit of a hard time. In 2007, I had a big accident. I got electrocuted and I fell 8 meters, and I was in hospital. And a month and a half later, I was about to start my contract, my first big contract with Cirque Phoenix. And the one memory I have was how much care there was for me, not just from the direction team, but almost every single person that worked at Phoenix. There was a real sense of family, and that's something that really moved me and touched me. Another memory was, yeah, this almost in the same line, was that how Alan, being the founder and director of Cirque Phoenix, would every day make an effort to go to every person that worked there and say hello, say good morning, say good afternoon, say good evening, and find out how everyone was doing. And I think that's something that's really nice and special about Phoenix, is that they really do care about everyone that works there. And then I think, of course, working, having the opportunity to work there for 12 years, it's something I think you have to experience to fully understand. But to be able to grace that stage on a daily basis and have 6,000 public members watch what you do and appreciate what you do, and then at the end of the show receive a standing ovation, I think that's a feeling that will never leave me. I am living in Germany. I have a little family. I have a little daughter. Her name is Nayla. She's also going to be a little clown for sure. She's going to follow in her dad's footsteps. I teach at various circus schools here in Germany, and I still perform I think performing has always been a passion of my life, and it will never leave me. And teaching is my way of giving back to people what I have learned and what I have experienced in the past. You know, with the performing arts, be it circus or theater or music or dance, it really has a powerful way of breaking down social barriers and bringing people together. And I still feel in this day and age that it doesn't receive the amount of respect from the outside world. When I look at my way or when I look at my experiences from being a part of Cirque Phoenix family, you can almost bring it into your personal life. You know, when we start a contract there or a season, you know, you have people from so many different countries all coming together, working together for a common goal. You have people from different religions, different races, different sexes, and yet somehow we find a way to make it work. Even though we have differences and different cultures and different views and different beliefs, we all have a common goal, and we work together to not just make an amazing show, but to create such an experience for any public member that walks into the tent from the start to the finish. And I think that's something that's almost lacking in this world, in that you can be different, yet we're all the same at the end of the day. We're all humans. And it's okay to disagree, and it's okay to have different views, and it's okay to come from different countries. Yet if we find a common goal, we can all work together through proper communication, respect and understanding. There's an old saying that the show will go on, and I really believe this, that no matter what happens, the show must always go on. And I think that's the same with life. Life will go on. That's just the kind of message I want to send to everybody, that with proper communication and proper education, I think this world can be a much better place.